started on the railway in 1970, trainee train driver, then became train driver, then an inspector, then I became a manager. I suddenly just shut down one day. I found myself at home and I thought, you know, where am I? The wife said, what's wrong with you? And I said, I don't know. She took me to the doctor and the doctor said, I think he's had a breakdown. I got treated for bipolar for a year, which is the worst thing that ever happened in my life because they're giving you lithium and it shuts you down and you lose your ability to speak. My wife was saying, he hasn't got bipolar. You know, she kept fighting, saying, he hasn't got bipolar. I got to see a psychiatrist and he says, good news is you haven't got bipolar. The bad news is you have young onset dementia, Alzheimer's. And it just felt as if your whole world had collapsed. I found out you get this superpower when you get dementia. You can go into a room full of people. They'll talk around you, about you, and over you. So you've got the ability to become invisible. And it used to be the loneliest place in the world because no one had talked to you. I go to this meeting, the first meeting, and they start talking about what it's like living with dementia and how people with dementia feel. I said, what you're saying is nothing like what it's like to have dementia. So I explained what it was like from my point of view and what it was like to actually have dementia. Chris Clark and Henry Mooney were there from Everton in the community. He said, we've started a new group, will you come and do a little talk there? I went down, did the talk, and then Henry Mooney said, do you want to come every week? And I thought, somewhere to go every week, because there was nothing. I started coming to Everton in the community, pass on the memories, started getting my confidence back again. This group has actually saved my life. It's made my life, it is my life. When you were stuck in the house in one little chair, you come out and then you become friends and then you become a community. I've learned how to use iPads and these are new skills that people have learned. So instead of being lonely there and that, didn't keep in contact with the family all the time. They always say, you're suffering with Alzheimer's. Well, there's no physical pain whatsoever with dementia. But people always insist that you're suffering with dementia, which you're not. I live with dementia, you know, and I'm living well with dementia now. Pass on the memories is so unique, and everyone looks to Everton in the community. Pass on the memories as the catalyst to what their group should be.